With the Democrats making no progress on the For the People Act, at least for now, they've decided to take a different tack. And the Democrats in the House have now introduced legislation aimed at restoring the Voting Rights Act of 1965, which was gutted by a 2013 Supreme Court ruling. This, of course, is the John Lewis Voting Act, which you've probably heard a lot about. It is not new, it's been around for a bit, it's being reintroduced. And this, by the way, is the voting rights legislation that people like Joe Manchin say that they support. The For the People Act goes too far. He generally says very vaguely, probably has an issue with the corruption, anti-corruption measures and stuff like that. But anyway, let's talk about the path for this and how likely it is to actually be passed. House leaders expect to pass the bill named the John Lewis Voting Rights Advancement Act after the late civil rights icon during a rare August session next week. They say it would restore the full force of the Voting Rights Act of 1965 after a pair of adverse Supreme Court rulings, and that it would help combat a wave of restrictive new election laws in Republican-led states. Only one Republican, Senator Lisa Murkowski of Alaska, is likely to support the legislation, leaving Democrats far short of the 60 votes they would need to break a Republican filibuster and send the bill to President Biden's desk. So what would it actually do? Well, again, it would take back what the Supreme Court took away. The most consequential ruling of that, and it's not the only part, but it is part of it, back in 2013, justices effectively invalidated a section of the law that required states and localities with a history of discriminatory voting rules to clear any changes to their elections policies with the federal government. At the time, the justices said that the formula used to determine which states were subject to clearance was out of date and invited Congress to update it. So there was a long documented record of these states providing racially discriminatory voting maps in a variety of different forms. Prior to 2013, they had to have them pre-cleared by the DOJ. So they couldn't simply implement them and then see if there was a challenge. They had to preemptively get them to be cleared. That was taken away. And what do you know, there's been a ton of racially discriminatory systemic voter disenfranchisement since then. So that said, JR, what are your hopes? What do you think?
Well, we like to talk about how we don't want to have these overreaching things that don't include bipartisanship with our legislation. So I'm sure you're going to get to this part about this, but the way that these states are reacting has nothing to do with bipartisanship, has nothing to do with fair voting, has nothing to do with allowing folks to vote freely in their state. And in fact, it targets specific people based off racial and partisan lines. So I wonder what this whole thing about the bipartisanship that they talk about and the fairness in our elections they like to talk about, as they blatantly do the exact opposite. So I guess nationwide, we're supposed to have these fairness laws and these split down the middle voting laws, but in each state, it just doesn't matter. In fact, it has to be worse in certain states to push these things. And if we're worried about the Supreme Court in 2013 ruled that these things are out of date for the states that they're determining have this history of racial issues with their voting, they're proving who has the issues with racial voting right now. So if you need some proof, they're providing it to you right now. So can we re-implement those things? Because the proof is right here in front of us.
Well, and isn't it amazing that, like, to continue on their thing of the proof, the Supreme Court's like, you know, it's not that you don't need something like this. I just think that the list of states is wrong. So you can just come up with a new list of states and then pass that, when we know the Republicans are going to filibuster it. Why? Because the national level Republicans are no better or less opposed to democratic rights and more fundamentally racist than those working at the state level producing the maps there. So before, you had a hemming in of the state level Republicans, and now there's this pretend that we're supposed to just play that the senators are any better, but they're not. You cannot pass a new listing of states or whatever, or new standards for producing it. For the same reason, by the way, and let's get to this now, that you can't pass the John Lewis Voting Rights Advancement Act. You can't pass it, okay? The people like Joe Manchin, others were like, well, the For the People Act, it goes too far. Let's just do this. And he had questions at the time, which is, well, but you're not gonna have any Republicans. And he said the stupid thing that he always says, which is, no, there are reasonable Republicans, we can get them. They've got one. And we're sort of just assuming that Lisa Murkowski would actually vote for it. I have no idea. But one might as well be none. 51 might as well be zero, because you can't pass any legislation. And so as it stands right now, there's not gonna be a For the People Act. There's not gonna be a John Lewis Voting Rights Act. There's not gonna be any re-implementation of the Voting Rights Act, which was destroyed. There's going to be nothing. And we could easily fix this by getting rid of the filibuster or even carving out an exception for voting rights legislation. I think that that's stupid, unnecessary, but you could do it, but they're not gonna do that, JR. Yeah. So we get to talk about how necessary this is, and the next part of this block is gonna be that, but they're not gonna do it.
They're just not gonna do it. And also, you brought up Joe Manchin, he knows that. He knows what math is, you know, from 50 to 60, he knows that. But the thing is, he's betting on himself. Again, if you sit and actually listen to every time Joe Manchin speaks and talks about this bipartisanship, he comes back to himself. He brings up West Virginia or he brings up himself. This is all he cares about. So it's okay if we don't get the Voting Rights Act. It's okay if Democratic voters get disenfranchised at a high level. It doesn't matter that minorities continue to get disenfranchised as well at the state level. It doesn't matter, because all he cares about is whether or not enough Republicans in West Virginia will vote for him, because he's fooled them into believing that he's a Republican as well. And also trying to fool Democrats and believing that he's a Democrat as well. In reality, he is a Joe Manchin. He's concerned about himself. So if everyone else loses their rights and we get another Republican president put in place and we get the control of the House and Senate by Republicans, if Joe Manchin still has his seat, he's like, mission accomplished. I don't care about anything else. I'm still here. And that's the card that he's playing.
Even if by design, with the process you just laid out, the seat is effectively meaningless when it comes to the actual exercise of power. It's not 100% meaningless. He likes it. There's a prestige to it. He gets thrown money. He'll eventually have a lobbying job. But insofar as it actually affects his constituents in a positive way, he is guaranteeing that he'll be there and that it'll be pointless. It's similar in some ways to the the cases where there's gerrymandering maps that are produced that protect a couple of incumbents with effectively districts they can never lose in, even though overall the result is that their own party gets underrepresented in the legislature. But for them, you know, it works out pretty well.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.